Greetings from Paediatric Cardiology and Paediatric Cardiothoracic Surgery team from Narayana Superspeciality Hospital, Howrah. Myself, Dr. Sanjiban Ghosh. I am Associate Consultant in Department of Paediatric Cardiology. Today we have with me Dr. Amitabha Chattopadhyay, who is Senior Paediatric Cardiologist and Head of the Department in Paediatric Cardiology, and Dr. Debasis Dash, who is Senior Cardiothoracic Surgeon in Narayana Superspeciality Hospital, Howrah. Today we shall discuss few practical points regarding the diagnosis and management of congenital heart disease. My first question to Dr. Amitabha Chattopadhyay, sir, how to diagnose congenital heart disease? Is it possible to diagnose this in utero?
Yes, it is. It is possible to diagnose in utero, and it can be done preliminary by look at the four chamber view by the trained obstetricians and radiologists, or by a specialized echocardiogram known as fetal echocardiogram, which is done usually by trained pediatric cardiologists or by radiologists and sonologists. It is usually done in our country at the age of 18 to 24 weeks.
Okay, so sir, what are the conditions can be picked up by doing a fetal echocardiography?
Usually 85 to 90% of the conditions can be picked up by fetal echocardiography. Smaller conditions like very small VSDs or coarctation of the aorta, or in the case that some of the holes and tubes in the heart are considered as normal, like a PDA or an ASD, this cannot be diagnosed in utero because these are considered normal. So we always advise them to do a neonatal echo after the baby is born.
So what is the present situation, scenario of fetal echocardiography in eastern part of the India?
In eastern part of the India, unfortunately, the situation is that we do not refer all the pregnant ladies for a fetal echocardiogram. Like we, on the proportionately, ladies from the other parts of the world or from even from other parts of India, they have a higher proportion of fetal echocardiogram reference. This may be due to the fact that most of the people, they are not aware as of the fetal echocardiogram facilities in different parts, especially in Bengal. But I think this should be as part of the curriculum or part of the program for all ladies.
Okay, so fetal echocardiography is still not a regular, like a routine diagnostic tool. So suppose somebody has missed fetal echocardiography, which is a very common situation in our society. So after delivery, what are the signs and symptoms from which a parents can diagnose or parents can suspect that the child may have a congenital heart defect?
In these cases, usually the mother is the first informant, and the mother comes up with the symptoms that the child is having, like baby is having a difficulty in suckling, or is tiring after a few feeds, having tremendous sweating with cold and clammy feet, or the baby is turning blue and is not breathing properly, is having very common, very frequent lower respiratory tract infections, and is requiring frequent hospitalizations, not gaining weight properly, so on and so forth. These are the common symptoms which the parents usually present with, and then they are examined by the pediatrician.
So suppose we have diagnosed a case of congenital heart disease. After diagnosis, what are the treatment options for them?
After diagnosis, the treatment options are mainly twofolds. Most of them are rather threefolds. First of all, the medications. These medications obviously cannot revert back the structural deformity which has occurred. These medications are given to facilitate and cure the symptoms from which the baby is suffering. Number two, we can have some catheter-based interventions and catheter-based treatment which can be done at the cath lab. For example, opening up stenosed valves or closed valves, or even closing some of the holes, or putting some stents in some narrow areas. And the third and the most important part is the surgical part, where the cardiac surgeons, they open up the heart or open up the chest to put in and correct some of the defects with their own eyes, visualizing under their own eyes.
So my next question is to Dr. Debasis Das, sir. Sir, there is a common belief that if the child is requiring a congenital heart surgery, that is the end of the world for them. So I would like to know, what is the long-term outcome of those child who is undergoing an open heart surgery?
Thank you, Sanjeevan, for that question. I think that thing at the outset is not true. Okay. I think one, congenital heart disease is a very common condition. It's not as uncommon as we think. So out of 10,000 children which are born, 7 to 8 of them will have some amount of heart disease. We are likely to have a heart disease. 2 or 3 will actually require an operation within first year of their life. So it is as common as that. And if treated in time, if treated at a proper center during when the diagnosis is supposed to be made and the patient undergoes a successful surgery, after that most of these children would actually lead a very meaningful life. They can actually go to school. the developmental progress is almost normal, if not near normal. If you compare it to other diseases like, say, birth asphyxia, Down syndrome, other syndromes where there are challenges in development, this is probably one disease in which, if treated in time, these children can actually have a very meaningful life.
Okay. So definitely it's not like an end of
world. It is definitely not end of world for the parents. Okay. As long as the awareness is there, it can be treated.
Yes, sir. Sir, another belief is that in the prevailing in the society, in the community, among the parents, even among the pediatrician also, that the child should have at least a minimum body weight to undergo a cardiothoracic surgery, open heart surgery or cardiopulmonary bypass surgery. Suppose, like I have heard that probably 10 kg is the minimum weight that the child has to have to undergo a cardiothoracic surgery. Is it really true?
No, in the current era, that is definitely not true. As I said, out of sort of total amount of congenital heart disease, around 2 per 10,000 patients will actually require an operation within first year of life if treated in normal time. So how can they be 10 kgs? That was the dictum followed when this specialty was being developed in the past. Now, that is no longer true. There are children, it basically depends on what condition does the child have. There are certain conditions in which you might require an operation within few hours of birth, within few days of birth. So that is no longer true. It just has to be seen. There are certain conditions in which you can wait to become more than 10 kgs, wait to become around, say, more than 1 year and then get operated. They are a minority of most of the other congenital heart disease will require an operation which is serious enough to require an operation within first year of life. And it is perfectly safe to operate on children less than 10 kg, even less than 5 kg for that matter. Certain kids are as so sick that they will require an operation within few days of life. So, and that can be safely done. And that is the message that should percolate to the society. Okay. That it is not true that the child has to be.
There is no weight criteria for.
There is no weight criteria. It depends on that particular child and the condition of the heart. And we have to individualize it to that particular child.
Another question, sir. What are the risks? Like, what is the success rate, if we talk in terms of percentage, for the children who is undergoing a cardiac surgery?
So, as I said, the conditions of the heart are very varied. So, some are very simple defects, some are very complex defects. If we overall take everything together, so in most of the centers who are doing congenital heart surgery, with sufficient experience, it would be less than 5%. So, only less than 5 in 100 would actually have serious problems or will not survive the operation. The simpler defects, they are as good as sort of less than 1%. But one of the most complex defects also can be treated around 5% sort of mortality rate, which means 95% of these children would actually have a good outcome if treated in time.
My next question is to Amitabha sir. Sir, what is the present situation of pediatric cardiac intervention in our hospital, in Narayana Superspeciality Hospital?
The present situation in our hospital, I would like to impart on the fact that we have a robust unit which comprises of three consultants and our DNB program, PGTs, and we have a team which is working 24/7 to the cause of these people. So, I take the example of last year when I had done about 750 cath lab cases, which comprises of diagnostic cardiac catheterizations plus interventions. And we had a variety of interventions, starting from neonatal age group to the almost even adult ones, where we have treated the adult congenital cases. We had a variety of holes to be closed, for example, the ASDs, VSDs, or PDs, variety of stenosed ducts or stenosed valves to be opened up. Or we had different kinds of stentings, including ductal stenting, right ventral outflow tract stenting, walk-resistant stenting, collateral stenting, and so on and so forth. So our intervention percentage was approximately 68%, and the diagnostic cardiac catheterizations have come down to a bare minimum, where they were really needed to understand the anatomy and to facilitate the surgery in those cases.
My next question is to Debasis sir. Sir, what is the present situation in our hospital regarding pediatric cardiothoracic surgery?
So, in the last 3 years, consistently we have done more than 500 cardiac surgical cases, congenital I'm talking about, every year. And last year we did 600 cases, out of which around more than 500 were children with serious congenital heart defects. And of them, around 40% of them were actually less than 1 year of age. And as I said, the earlier diagnosis and earlier intervention is the current modality of therapy. And we were fortunate that around 40% of these patients actually came in time and got operated within first year of their life. So that's what we did last year.
Thank you very much to both of you. I would like to request Dr. Debasis Das to conclude the session.
I think congenital heart disease, as we started this discussion amongst the three of us, is basically a condition which is determined by a lot of things. Some of it is genetic, some of it is structural abnormality during development. So once it happens, I think the main thing is awareness of the parents and the society. So as the message that we wanted to give is that congenital heart disease is not the end of the world. Obviously, it's a stressful situation for the parents, that we understand. But if detected in time, as Dr. Amitabha and Sanjeevan was saying, if detected in time and a proper planning is done as to when this person should be operated upon and treated in a center which has the requisite infrastructure in terms of having the surgical as well as the cardiological expertise for it, having a proper intensive care person and an intensive care nursing facility where these kids, because some of these children will require a pretty good infrastructure as well as a physician support for getting through the surgery. So if they are treated in a facility which has these things, I think they'll have a successful outcome, and most of the children will actually lead a pretty meaningful life, go to school, play low intensity sports, and will become economically productive citizen in future. So that is the message, that it is not the end of the world. It is a challenge to the parents, and if it's treated in time, they will grow up to become meaningful individuals.
Thank you very much. So timely diagnosis and timely treatment is the key of success. Thank you.
Thank you.